Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. So as the title says, today's video is going to be a handbag review video. It's going to be all about the wear and tear and in-depth detail about the favorite MM, and mine is in the monogram print. Before we jump into today's video, if you're new here, hi, this is Mona. And if you like my channel, please do consider subscribing and also do hit the like button if you like today's video. So let's jump into today's video. So this is my bag. I bought this bag from the Crystal Small, the Louis Vuitton store in Crystal Small in Vegas, and I bought it in the beginning of 2017. It was the mid of Jan 2017 during our trip to Vegas. I exactly don't remember for how much I purchased this, so I will leave the pricing somewhere here on the screen. So first let's talk about the wear and tear of this bag. I don't see any corner wear on this one. Like, it is like pretty much in brand new condition, and even at the back or anywhere, I don't see any wear on the canvas. The leather, so the leather has some slight patina. It has like aged a little bit, a darkened a little bit, but it is not like too dark or anything of that nature. I still do have the the protective wrap, what do you call it, the protective cover, the protective layer, like the thin sheet on the top, because I don't see a need, because it does not show up too much. If you can see it, it still looks like it does not have any protective layer on top of it, so I just left it as it is. When it starts peeling off, I thought I'll take it out. Moving on to the inside of the bag. This is the bag has like a very beautiful an eggplant color, dark eggplant color interior, like a dark burgundy, and on the inside too I don't see any wear at all. It's still in a very good condition. So most of the time I don't use this bag on the days where I have like a long day. So this one comes out with me for like vacations, or it comes out with me when I go for like a quick errand or something like that. So it's very handy for that purpose. I don't tend to put too much stuff in it, so I don't, there has never been a chance where anything got spilled inside or something. But there is one mark on the inside. I don't know whether it will show up properly on this lighting. Can you see? Yeah, there's like a white marking on the interior. I really have no clue on how it happened, and it does not bother me at all, because it's somewhere on the side of the interior, and it's been there since like the first or second usage. I have no clue what I put inside and what made that mark on the interior. But yeah, that is a one wear I have on this bag. That would be not on the, I wouldn't say it's a wear. It's like a wear from my regular usage. It's not like the bag is bad or something like that. Moving on to the wear on the straps. I cannot tell too much about it, because I've used the strap like even just like once or twice maybe. But I really don't tend to use this strap, because I'm very scared or worried that I may get some strain on the leather. So I always use the pochet metal strap, which has been working absolutely fine. I did spill, I or my kids, I don't exactly remember, I would say we did spill some water on the strap, and the watermark does show up. Do you see there's like slight watermarks over here? So yeah, that is pretty much it. So that too will show up only if you have to like look into it very closely. Otherwise it doesn't show up at all. Otherwise it's a pretty good strap, just it's not perfect for my lifestyle. As I have to roam around with kids, I always get very cautious that I may end up ruining the strap. So I just let it rest in my closet and I use the other one. From the usage perspective, I tend, personally for my lifestyle, I tend to use it more like a crossbody bag rather than as like a shoulder bag or as a clutch. At the end of this video, I will definitely show you the mod shots of me wearing this bag in multiple ways. But just for let you know, I'm 5'2" for your reference and about like 100 lbs. But I never tend to use this bag as a crossbody or a clutch bag. It has worked amazing for me as a crossbody bag. So sometime last year, I exactly don't remember, during the beginning of my YouTube period, I have done a video of me comparing this one with the Louis Vuitton Neverfull bags pouch, just to do a size comparison and what fits inside. So I will leave that video's link somewhere here. Don't make fun of me for that video, because that was my initial stage of YouTubing, and I was recording those videos using my mobile phone. So just pardon the quality of that video, but the content as such, the information I have put in that video is legit. So like, it's my perfect thoughts during that time. So other than that, this bag, to talk about how it holds its shape, it has held its shape pretty much really, really well. It is not like a slouchy thing. It is a really a proper structured bag, I would say. For a canvas bag, it's like really kept up its shape really, really well. Talking about the dimensions of the bag, again, I'll leave it somewhere in the video over here or somewhere. I'll just put all the like the height, the width and the depth, all the measurements from the Louis Vuitton side. I also leave the details down below. So I don't have the favorite in the PM size, but I have seen it. It depends, it's a personal choice. For me, I definitely prefer the MM over the PM, because the PM, I feel it's more like a clutch bag rather than a crossbody bag. But this one will work great for both like a clutch bag and also as a crossbody bag. That's just my personal opinion. It may change from person to person. So that is all about the bag. So let's see how this bag fits on me. So that's all for today's video. Hope you really liked it. Have a happy Wednesday and have a happy rest of the week too. Also, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and also the bell icon next to it. See you guys next time. Take care. Bye-bye.